I did my PhD a long time ago. It was a bit of it was on using the Antarctic dry valleys as an analog for Mars, and looking at the sediments and stuff, and you know what would you expect to find on Mars? Where would you look for it? How does organic matter get preserved? All that kind of stuff.
So that's even kind of a sort of finding point as to how you would find life on Mars.
Yeah, what are the signs of lakes, old lakes on Mars, for instance? You know, so I work a lot on the lakes and the dry valleys, and when they dry up, and what kind of deposits do they leave, and what's the evidence that life was there and stuff. So I was thinking of getting back into that more.
I'm actually, tomorrow we're going out to NASA Ames and then SETI,
Yeah.
And there's a guy who does modeling of Mars, climate modeling.
What's his name? Haberly?
Adrian, I forget his surname.
Oh, okay.
But, So, while we're on that topic, could you describe how your research into Antarctica gives insights or possible insights into Martian climate?
So I work in the dry valleys, which is one of the coldest and driest areas on Earth. And it's called dry because there's no glaciers there, you know, but we get snow and the snow melts and glaciers melt and form lakes in the bottom of the valley. And so for years I've been looking at that as a model for not modern Mars, but what Mars was like in the past. And so, you know, we have these ice-covered lakes that are probably the, you know, we imagine on Mars that they may have been the last vestige of life on Mars. You know, that we have the saying that the last swim of life on Mars was an ice-covered lake like the dry valleys, you know. So the, as the lakes evaporated and Mars cooled, left behind deposits that now these rovers are going up to look at. And so it gives you an idea of what to look for and what's the evidence that life was there.
And is there any interesting results that you've obtained from that research?
Yeah, you know, I've been out of it for a while, but I'm getting back into it. And the big thing now are these deltas, you know, that the rivers flow down into the lakes and leave deltas behind. And now the Curiosity rover that's up there right now on Mars, you know, they're finding these ancient deltas. And so, you know, some of the work I've done in the past on these deltas, looking at carbon isotopes and whatnot, could actually give some clues to what that evidence that they're finding is telling them.
How does Mars climate differ from Earth?
Mars is a lot colder. Not that much colder, actually. It gets way, way cold and it gets warm, you know, so the average is lower than Antarctica, but not that much lower. It's kind of surprising. But the extremes are much more variable. You know, it gets really, really cold at night, and it gets above freezing some places in the soils during the day. So, you know, not too far off, but there's very few places on Earth that are that extreme. You not only have to go to Antarctica, you have to go Antarctica and go high elevation to get closer to modern-day Mars.